So it's been a while since we've burnt anything here at Exhibition Chemistry. Time to rectify that. Yes, this month we're going to be returning to the home of all the best things that go bang, pop and whiz, and that's of course the reactivity series. So this demonstration is going to be showing something to do with the true reactivity of aluminium. When I normally show this, I tend to be showing it to students who have already seen reactions of metals with metal compounds and also reactions of metals with acids. So they've got an idea of the fact that a reactive enough metal is going to produce hydrogen with some acid. They got the idea that different acids tend to behave in the same way as long as they're the same concentration. And they've got the sort of basic idea of displacement reactions. And of course, one of the main problems with the displacement reactions when you want to talk about aluminium is the fact that it's protected by this coating of aluminium oxide, and that sort of prevents us from seeing its true reactivity. So the first thing we need to do is just sort of just put some aluminium in the bottom of these 250ml flasks. I've got about 20 centimetres here by about 8 centimetres, roughly the sort of diameter of the flask. And I'm just loosely rolling that up just to enough to help me to get it through, but I'm not sort of crushing it too much so that I'm sort of preventing the solutions from getting in and doing their business. And a splint or something can just sort of help you get that so that it's sort of flat down on the bottom. I mean, it doesn't have to be pressed, but sort of down towards the bottom of the flask there. Okay, so we've got two lots of aluminium here, and to my left and to my right, we've got some acid solutions. Okay, we've got 50 millilitres of each. On my left, we've got sulfuric acid, and that's going to be paired up with copper sulfate. So we've got sort of the sulfate element common there. And then here we've got hydrochloric acid, and that's going to be paired up with copper chloride. Again, the chloride element being common. And just to try and keep things sort of fair, we've got 0.5 molar sulfuric acid, whereas we have 1 molar hydrochloric acid. So to all intents and purposes, when I'm explaining this to students, we've got the idea that both of these contain the sort of same amount and concentration of acid particles effectively. So if we dissolve up the copper sulfate, there's about 3.5 grams here. It doesn't really matter too much. It's just a ballpark figure. And just give that a swirl. I'll leave that for a second while I do the same thing for the hydrochloric acid and the copper chloride. Chuck it in there, it's all good. Give that a clean. And you might want to point out, or just spend a minute or two, of course, explaining the slight difference in the colours of the solutions. But the key thing to point out with both is that they are coloured. They have this sort of bluish or bluey-green colour, and that's telling us, of course, that we have these copper ions in solution. That's going to become more important later on. And I'm going to just add these in here, starting off with the copper sulfate. So this is going to be our control, our benchmark for the students to think about. So you may want to ask them, you know, what do they think is going to happen? We might expect for a fairly reactive metal that we might see hydrogen bubbles, we might see some kind of a displacement reaction coming along. What will that look like in terms of the products that are being formed? Exciting. Or not. Okay, so of course, here we have the sort of disappointing reaction that students might see, that it's not going to really help them to see the fact that aluminium is actually pretty reactive. If this were magnesium, we'd be seeing quite a lot of hydrogen being produced, certainly, and the metal dissolving. None of the above happening here. What we need is something that's going to help us to break down that aluminium oxide layer. So in here we have the only difference being we have chloride ions in with the acid instead of the sulfate ions. And the chloride ions are going to be able to ligate the aluminium ions on the aluminium oxide surface, and just help to break down that protective layer, exposing the aluminium underneath, and we'll get an idea of just how reactive it is. Of course, again, similar kind of expectations about what we might expect to see. Maybe we might see copper being produced from the displacement, maybe we'll see bubbles of gas, and of course, when you do this, you'll know that there will be gas being produced. So I tend to have a lit splint ready so that I can chuck this in at the point where I think we're sort of reaching the peak amount of gas, and the result is actually really pleasing. Let's have a look. Okay, splint's ready. If I hold this up here, you can probably hear that there's already gas being produced. I'm going to give that a few more seconds so it's definitely going. There we go. And we get this really cool hydrogen flame, picking up, of course, the green colour of the dissolved copper. And that will keep going for about, on a good day, at least sort of 20 seconds or so. Keep the splint handy, because you may get a second go out of this. If you find, if you find that the flame is self-extinguishing and it's just sort of burning inside the flask, you're not going to get anything else coming from this. If you have that as a problem from the off with your flask, it's worth trying a little bit more copper chloride in the mixture to start off with. But you may, if you're sort of quick about this, get a couple of goes before the reaction reaches a point where it's no longer going to be able to sustain that flame. So, things to point out, of course, we now have a flask that's very hot. It's sort of okay to handle for a few seconds, but you know, there's definitely a lot of heat being produced here, both from the flame, but it's not just from the flame, it's the base of the flask is pretty warm as well. Okay, and we've got these really obvious colour changes here as we produce copper in the displacement reaction, therefore inferring that our aluminium is dissolving into solution as aluminium chloride in one of a number of forms, it's likely. And of course, that the fact that the solution is going colourless. And after a minute or two, it will be almost completely colourless, if not colourless. So really nice, simple demonstration to work with. If you dim the lights, you get such a nice sort of will-o'-the-wisp type effect. Definitely worth trying with your students. Give it a go.